CVS security guard. You're always safe with Harold on the job. And our fourth contestant is Kathy, host of Kathy's Cupcakes. She is a stay-at-home mom with 9 children consisting of 8 boys and 1 girl. All right, folks, let's get right to the facts, starting with Bill.
Your body's creating and killing 15 million red blood cells per second.
Interesting. Melissa!
Well, Chad, did you know during your lifetime you eat about like 60,000 pounds of food? That's the weight about like six elephants.
Heavy. Harold.
Fact, the oldest piece of chewing gum is 9,000 years old.
Disgusting. Kathy.
Well, Chad, did you know that a sneeze travels out of your mouth at over 100 miles per hour?
Like, I chew.
Oh, Melissa, darling, here you go.
Well, that was a riveting round one. Round two, Bill.
A man named Charles Osborne once had hiccups for 68 years.
That's a long time. Melissa!
Well, Chad, did you know if you counted 24 hours a day, it would take 31,688 years to reach 1 trillion?
That's a lot of math. Harold.
Fact, the longest recorded chicken flight is 13 seconds.
Who knew chickens could fly? Kathy!
Well, Chad, did you know that windmills always travel counterclockwise, except for the windmills in Ireland?
Well, folks, back to Bill.
Did you know the placement of a donkey's eyes in its head enable it to see all 4 feet at all times?
Melissa!
Well, Chad, did you know that most lipsticks contain fish scales?
Ew. Harold.
Fact, it is illegal to pawn your dentures in Las Vegas. Not that I've done it before.
Brush your teeth, kids. Kathy.
Oh, dear. I'm just feeling a little flustered right now. I'm gonna have to excuse myself. Y'all enjoy these cupcakes, though. I baked them this morning.
Oh, so sorry. Thanks for playing. Believe it or not, we're down to 3 contestants now. Let's see what they have for us next. Bill.
There are more plastic flamingos in the U.S. than real ones.
That's a lot of plastic. Melissa!
Well, Chad, did you know that snails can sleep for 3 years without eating?
Harold.
Fact, slugs have 4 noses.
Back to Bill.
A hardworking adult sweats up to 4 gallons per day.
Melissa!
Dude, I don't think I can think of any more. I'm like sweating right now and I'm getting a breakout in this area. I've gotta go. Bye.
It's really getting tough now. Harold.
Fact, only female mosquitoes bite.
By lying your back and raising your legs, you won't sink in quicksand.
Fact, Eskimos use refrigerators to keep their food from freezing.
Termites work twice as fast when listening to heavy metal music.
Fact, a baker from Texas made a fruitcake that was 5 feet wide, 6 feet tall, and weighed 150 pounds. Beat that.
Bill, do you have another fact? 5 seconds.
2,000 years ago, a woman who was a virgin had a baby in a stable. This baby was God's son who came down to earth and was later crucified and came back to life so that we too could have eternal life. Top that.
Do you have anything more bizarre than that?
Fact. No, I do not.
Well, folks, you heard it right here. That's right. Woman, baby, stable, God's son, came back from dead. So it's up to you two, believe it or not.
Thank you. look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look in the 5 and 10.
Listening once again,
with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, but the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots at the wish of Barney and Ben.
Dolls that'll talk and will go for walks, the hope for Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go.
Now there's a tree in the Grand Hotel.
One in the park as well.
The sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start.
And the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within. Boots and a pistol that shoots
is the wish of Barney and Ben.
Dolls that'll talk and will go for a walk
is the hope for Janice and Jen.
And the mom and dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within.
Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. This season, when we see that bright red bucket and hear that wonderful, wonderful bell, let's think about our heart posture and let's consider giving like never before.
Thank you. Thank you. place as big as the sea. I'm looking for the star right now. I wonder where you are right now.
Thank you. Just me and my first mate.
Billy! Did anyone see him after the boat went down?
I did.
If something happened to him, I'll never forgive myself. I couldn't have saved the SS Mango without him.
Billy!
Oh, here you are. Billy, you scared me. I thought we lost you. Where have you been?
I was so busy thinking, I got lost. I've been trying to remember something I was supposed to do, but I forgot.
Whatever it was, it isn't important now, Billy. Why don't you head back to the crash site and see what's salvageable from the Mango?
Aye, aye, Captain.
The cruise of a lifetime.
celebrate Christmas on the biggest cruise ship in the Caribbean, the Yuletide.
1 minute we're singing Christmas carols on a cruise ship with thousands of people. The next, we're on a tiny boat getting shipwrecked.
It's all my fault. I was the one who saw the brochure. The fabulous charter yacht, the SS Mango, will take you and your 10 lucky companions on a shopping excursion to Christmas Island you'll remember forever.
You gotta give them credit. They nailed that last part.
Now, hey there, you sad little rain clouds. Cheer up. Looks like we've got a bad case of the Mondays.
It's Friday.
Who are all these sad little people?
Who are you?
You know who I am. I'm Jessica, the cruise director on the Yuletide. I have the privilege to ensure everyone has a super-duper wonderful time on their cruise.
Well, Jessica, the first part, shopping on Christmas Island, was great. But the second part, the shipwreck, not so much.
But now you're getting a super wonderful free tour of a primitive island.
So, how long before you think they'll realize we're missing?
Well, I can assure you that by 7 o'clock on Christmas Eve, they'll know something's wrong.
What's so special about that?
That's when the big Christmas show on the Yuletide is supposed to start. Emma, Sophie, and Trent are actors and musicians and the stars of our Christmas show.
Don't worry, people. You're not going to miss the show. As soon as the storm hit, I had Billy send an SOS with our position. We'll be rescued in no time. But just to be extra careful, we should probably make some more preparations.
Hey, this might even give us a little extra time to rehearse for the Christmas show.
Good point, Sophie. We could always use more rehearsal.
First, I think we should break up into teams to forage for food, build shelter, and look for supplies. What can you three do to help?
I'm Chloe. This is Olivia and Mason. We're firefighters from Des Moines on Christmas vacation. Or we were.
Perfect! I want you three to look for supplies. Wood from the SS Mango likely washed up on the shore. Maybe some of our backpacks and packages too.
Are you sure you don't want the firefighters to forage for food?
Not when we've got musicians. Musicians know what it's like to be starving.
We got it!
Who are you?
I'm Jasmine. I'm with the ship's drama troupe.
Are you an actor or a musician?
Neither. I'm the ship's mime.
A mime? Come stand over here.
What do you want me to do, Captain?
I really can't think of a thing for a mime to do. Why don't you just stand right there?
And do nothing? But Captain, I can't just do nothing. A mime is a terrible thing to waste.
Oh, yes, you can. I just encased you in a glass box.
Captain, I'm the building contractor. Name's Logan. You give me the right materials and I'll have a shelter built by nightfall.
You'll get him.
Come on, everyone. By tonight, just on the off chance the rescuers haven't gotten here yet, we'll have shelter, food, and water.
We need a bottle.
Wow, we're making some progress here. If we actually did have to be stuck on this island for a while, it might not be so bad.
Captain, are you starting a fire so we can roast marshmallows? What a super idea.
No, Jessica. I'm trying to get a signal fire going in case the rescuers aren't sure which side of the island we're on when they get here. But I'm afraid the matches and wood are all waterlogged.
Captain, Captain! Great news!
What is it, Billy? Are the rescuers here?
No, but I finally remembered what I forgot. I forgot to send that SOS when the storm hit.
Oh, no! Billy!
I'm so relieved. That was driving me crazy.
No SOS? No rescuers?
No problem. I've already got that taken care of. Check this out. I found just one bottle washed up on shore.
A message in a bottle? It's already floating away. Did you write down our position accurately?
Of course I did. Got it right here. Help. Crew and passengers of SS Mango shipwrecked. Need rescue. I mean, there's the latitude and longitude. Check it yourself.
And what did you put in the bottle?
What do you mean? This message right here.
That exact one?
Yeah. You write the message, cork the bottle, throw the bottle into the ocean, and then put the message in the bottle.
Oh, no.
You know,
yeah!
The proper procedure for a message in a bottle is to put the message in the bottle and then throw it out. I should know.
Who are you?
Oh, the name's Johnny, Johnny Coconut. I'm what you call the local resident of this said island.
Resident? You live here on purpose?
On purpose? No. But I don't know the choice. You see, I was sailing around my sailboat around the world when I hit a ferocious storm. Been here ever since.
And how long have you been here?
I think I left in 1998. I think I make it home before 2000.
Oh, no.
Is your name really Johnny Coconut? That's just a super duperous name. You are just a hoop.
I must say, I never thought this day was gonna come. We're finally being rescued.
Well, Johnny, I hate to break it to you, but it seems we may be just as lost as you are. We thought we'd be getting rescued any minute, but now we're not so sure.
Oh, I hope we get back to the ship for Christmas. My whole family's waiting for me. We brought our Christmas stockings on the cruise and, like, everything.
So we really might miss Christmas?
No big Christmas show?
No big Christmas dinner?
No decorations? No Christmas trees?
Come on, you deserted island downers. We've got bags full of Christmas decorations. We might miss Christmas as we know it, but we can still have Christmas right here.
I know this may be not where you wanted to spend Christmas this year, but this may be the best Christmas I've had.
I bet you've been kinda lonely.
Boy, have I. For the last couple years, I did a Christmas gift exchange. I stopped doing it, though.
Why'd you stop?
I kept getting the same gift every year.
Johnny, do you have any idea where we are?
I'm afraid not.
But there can't be that many islands out here. Can there?
Chloe, this is Christmas Island, where we were. This is the cruise ship, and I think... this is us.
So we're castaways on an uncharted island?
But these islands are legendary. I suspect we've shipwrecked on one of the fabled ice cream islands.
You mean we're stranded on a desert island?
Captain, our shelter is complete, on time and under budget. Built completely from the wood from the mango that washed up on shore.
I'll miss the mango. She was a strong little boat.
Look, we found more mangoes.
Yay!
This is all well and good, but we can't just sit here. We've got to find a way to save ourselves.
Listen, we have to face facts. There's hundreds of miles of empty sea around us. We have no way to save ourselves.
Well, since you're all here, and we've got the place decorated for Christmas, and we even have a brand new audience. How about a little taste of the Christmas show?
It all begins long, long ago. God has promised the rescuer, and the people are waiting, waiting for the promised rescuer to come.
Rejoice, rejoice, He's coming soon. I long
thought of the Christmas story being a rescue story?
Well, the prophets foretold the coming Messiah, but then God was silent for 400 years. But many continued to believe God's promise to send a rescuer, and they kept waiting and watching for the Messiah.
And speaking of waiting and watching, I finally got a good signal fire going. Search plane should be able to see this for miles. We gotta keep it burning night and day.
And now the fire's out.
Firefighters are back.
Great job, firefighters! Way to go!
Not to complain, but that was our signal fire.
Sorry, it's just a reflex. We see fire, we put it out.
You travel with your fire clothes?
You didn't think we'd leave them at home. Did you?
Okay, yes, right, actually. Yes, I did.
We got all the bags for the mango off the shore, and everyone has theirs.
Wait, even the mime!
Does she think she's pulling a real rope?
Speak up! We can't hear you.
What you saying?
I speak mime. I'll translate. There's trouble. Billy is on the other beach. He has to plant fescue.
Fescue? Isn't that some type of grass?
No, wait. He has a plan to rescue us. He took 50 balloons.
50 balloons?
He filled them with hot air. He says he's going to float to civilization and get help.
The balloons will only get him out over the ocean before he falls. You all keep doing what you were doing. I'll go stop Billy and bring him back.
I'll go with you.
But we left off for God's people were waiting for 400 years.
Not that I was waiting for a long time to be rescued, but 400 years?
That's why I have such awesome, amazing news, Johnny. When the angel showed up near Bethlehem, announcing that the promised one had just been born.
The angel told the shepherds, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people.
For there is born to you this day in the city of David, a Savior who is Christ the Lord."
I learned all of that when I was in Sunday school, but I haven't really thought about it in a long time.
Like the angel said to the shepherds, Johnny, this is good news for all people, including Johnny Coconut.
Well, I guess I was just like some of those people you were talking about, who were lost in darkness. Maybe because of all the rotten things I've done, I didn't deserve to be rescued.
Oh no! Billy?
That kid! kid is as messed up as a kite in a hailstorm.
Billy, you look fabulous, doesn't he, everyone?
What happened to him?
I didn't get there before he lifted off. I wasn't able to stop him.
I was sure the balloons would take me 100 miles.
How far did they take you?
About 100 feet.
Oh. He must have been half a mile up in the sky. I wouldn't even have seen him if he hadn't been carrying a flashlight.
The flashlight was for signaling airplanes.
He only got about 20 yards offshore before the balloons started popping. You're lucky they didn't all go out at once.
Well, it was a good try, Billy.
Billy, we're almost climactic moment of our show. Why don't you settle in and join us?
Okay. I'm afraid all of my plans to save us have fallen flat anyway.
Well, then you might like this story then, Billy. Sure seems that God is in the rescue business, even when it doesn't happen at all like we're expecting.
What do you mean?
Well, people were lost in darkness, just like us. God promised them a savior, but they had to wait. An angel appeared to a young girl, Mary, and told her that the long-awaited savior would be born, and she should call him Jesus. When they were far away, just like us, angels appeared to a couple shepherds, and they filled the sky and told them that their savior had been born in Bethlehem.
Listen, everybody, we're gonna need a little bit of help for this next song.
What do you need?
We need you three firemen to go put on those robes. You are going to be our shepherds.
Captain, you, Logan, and Jasmine can be our sheep, cow, and donkey.
Brett and I will be Joseph and Mary.
Oh, and Billy, you should be the angel. Pretend you're up in the sky with a bright light.
I think I can pretend that.
Perfect! This will be just like the big show on the Yuletide!
When the angels have left and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one of them, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see the things that have happened, which the Lord had told us about." Luke 2:7-15.
Come, let her receive her King. Let her
Now that is an awesome rescue story right there. Look, even if we don't ever get off this island, I'm so glad I met you guys. Look!
What is it?
It's a bright light in the sky.
Another angel announcement?
This is just like our Christmas show. The prophet Isaiah said the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. And on those living in the land of the deep darkness, a light has dawned.
Or maybe a star?
Like the wise men who came to Jerusalem when Jesus was born, asking, "Where is the one who has been born, the King of the Jews? We saw a star when it rose and have come to worship him."
I'm not sure that's a star.
Are you from the SS Mago?
Yes, yes. I'm the captain. We got hit by a storm and ran aground on this island.
A lot of people back on the Yuletide are going to be very relieved.
Everyone was worried sick. They were praying all of you would return, even the mime.
Thank you so much for rescuing us.
We tried everything we could think of and just couldn't rescue ourselves.
We're glad we found you.
Hey, aren't there supposed to be 11 people?
Yeah, I count 12.
Oh, that extra one is me. I got lost a long time ago. Well, I reckon before you were born. The name's Johnny, Johnny Coconut.
No way! How long have you been here?
Ah, these are just biblical costumes. We've been helping with rehearsal.
Well, why don't you unpack your things? We'll fly you back to the Yuletide. I'm sure there's going to be an even bigger Christmas Eve party tonight.
So what made you search way over here?
The captain said we were too far away.
You were. We weren't searching over here.
What?
No, this is way, way out of the search area. We were on our way back to get fuel.
Then how did you see us? Our signal fire went out.
We're still not sure. The pilot swears she saw a flashlight glowing in the sky in the middle of a huge bunch of balloons.
Well, what do you know?
Okay, folks, you saw us lower down from the helicopter. That's because there isn't enough room to land on this small beach. So we'll need to hoist you up one at a time.
Another exciting thrill ride for no additional cost.
Seriously?
We'll attach you to the rope with the harness, and I'll be right beneath you. But you need to grab on tight. We'll have you back on board in no time.
Come on, everybody. Back to the Yuletide. We've got quite a story to tell.
So the home world can know it.
Sorry.